So I started out with two of these Vita inverter, 24 volts, 300 watts. It's not in production right now. This is what I started out with. Two of these Vita inverter. Then I move up to another type, which is a 1000 watt 24 volts, taking 2245 volts DC, and the efficiency was, I didn't know how to measure it too well because there was no indication of the output. Just use my clamp and meter and it works. Another two of these, they were grid tie, and it works extremely well. Stand up on a good one. And on the extreme lightning and thunder. Yeah. Look at that. Still good. It's not a good time for it. So after these work, I made a switch to a bigger inverter that can give me indication on the web as to what is happening. And this was the one I sourced. And this is what's happening right now. 2.7 kilowatt is going in right now off the solar panel, and for the morning so far, 5.13 kilowatt hour. And the total that I've produced so far over the past 2.5 months, look at it right there. You can hardly tell that this grid tie inverter is working. Fanless, no noise whatsoever. Shuts off at night, comes on in the morning. And look at it. Good sunshine. And this is what is happening. The two banks of panel going in. As I said before, I love it. That's the Wi-Fi antenna right there. Communicate with the router. Set it up, send all the information to that router, then I can access it from anywhere to see exactly what is happening. Display disappear, give it a tap, and it's reappear again. And to show you exactly how I have these panels set up, I made some adjustment in the angle until I'm satisfied that it's right. Monitor for a couple of days on the internet to see exactly what is happening, and from there I will decide, here's where I'm going to set, keep the angles so that I can capture maximum sunshine. Is that beautiful? She's beautiful. Okay, these are the panels in the easterly direction. One little shade there, and this is the other group. The all tide in series give you over 250 volts DC on that input. And as you can see, good sun, very clear. Oh yeah. So we're gonna have to just do some work and get these a little more sturdy, more permanent right where they are, and leave it that way. And as you can see, lots of cloud cover, but still brilliant sunshine. Good sunshine, nothing to complain about. They're all tied in series here. All right. And then about over 75 feet away from the grid tie inverter. So it's doing great. It's doing great. No obstruction yet. I don't think we'll have any for the day. Because as soon as there's an obstruction, you can see it in the production. Especially if there's a cloud cover that will come overhead, drops right down. So this is it. It's doing good. And we have wind. It's all wind and solar. It's all wind and solar. Missouri solar still going. Missouri wind turbine, rather, still going. No complaint. No complaint whatsoever about these turbines. No complaints. Still producing. Still grid tie too. Turbine is also grid tie. The impact of the production is not as great with the turbine as the solar, because at any time you can have, like now, those solar panels are being adding up to 3 kilowatts. Gotta get a bigger turbine for that. A lot more wind. But it trickles it every night, put in a little bit every night, as long as there is wind and no sun. So it's constant. And it's still rocking. Look at it. Move it for yourself. Get a Missouri wind and solar too. That is absolute proof that the grid tie is working. Working like a charm. As you can see exactly what is happening there. During the course of the day, it's crediting me absolutely with kilowatts of hours. And at night, there's some debit. But as long as we have good sunshine, every single day, it's a killer. Look at that. Look at that. Absolutely brilliant. Good, nice cloud for those panels. And it's doing justice. Take a look at the bills. So that's before I set up that main grid tie inverter, the super 5000 watt grid tie inverter. I was using some smaller grid tie and there was reduction in the energy bill so far. And then it goes on. And I put it in production on the 1st of July. And then, as you can see, on the 1st of July, the next bill, look at the reduction. Look at the reduction. That's the difference in kilowatt hour. Even though it was coming down all the time, even though it was reducing, look at that. Look at that. That's July. That's in July. And after that grid tie started produce more and more kilowatt hours, this is what the next bill is going to be. Look at it. Charge. That is the charge.